Okay, so I'm going to have a go at Marta's Five Supply Challenge. I'm just grabbing some scrapbook papers that can't go together. Okay, that'll do. So, what have we got on our list? Tissue, scrap papers, or scrapbook papers, washi tape, gouaches, and stamps. So, let's start with some scrapbook paper. Just gonna pop it down. This is just offcuts from other projects. I'm using it up. Since we're going to be using gouaches, maybe I should grab my mask, washi tape. Just put that down the middle before we get too carried away. Pop some on the back as well. Should we leave it at that? Do we want any more of that? Do we want any dark? No plan for this page, I'm just going with it. Whatever feels right. I think. drawer of the ink as well. Have a look at what tissue paper we have. Oh, what about this? So, this might go well. Fairly sturdy tissue paper. It's just from packaging from the shoes, I think. Something like. That brings in a nice colour of like pinks and blues there, along with the greys and browns, which is quite nice. Also adds some nice texture. And then let's add a nice strip across the middle because we've not got much connecting these two pages at the moment. Tiny bit more there. Tiny, tiny bit. Doesn't matter if it scrunches up, that's part of the texture. So there we go. The Americans would say it's looking a bit of a hot mess at the moment. So I think we'll leave it to dry and then we'll add some gesso. Washi tape. Let's get some washi tape down. I'm using the blue because there's some real blue flowers in the background. Some of this seems to have names on it. Things keep falling down, I have no idea what it is. I'm just gonna get some of this down, this background texture. Then I'm going to go in with some gesso. I think I'm going to use a baby wipe. Ugh. and make sure everywhere's got some gesso. But I'm going in slightly heavier in some places. Okay. Then next will be some gouaches, so we're going to let that dry and then we'll be back with some gouaches. Okay, so got my gouaches out. Let's add water to those, and I think I'm gonna let the water on the page. Grab my brush. Probably need to wet the brush. Just do that. And I think I'm gonna go for nice bright colours and just some colour on there because it's looking a bit grey and dull and all over me. That's okay, the gouache is the washer. What else have we got in there? Some blue maybe? Yep, that literally went on my face. We got anything in this little pad? Oh yes. Let's add the violet. Anything else? Let's think. green in there. Might be a bit muddy, but let's try. Just a tiny bit. That orange. Blue. There. I think I'm going to let that sit now. Do its thing. Let's try and find somewhere flat to put that. Right. And now we're going to try and just move this gouache pot without knocking the tripod over because it's not actually secure. Now then. So I'm going to use a butterfly stamp from Indigo Blue on this wax paper. What colour shall we use? Should we just use black? Yeah, just go for black. So, and I've got my stamp platform. Really flat spot. Doesn't matter, it's all creased and wrinkled, it just adds a bit interest and texture, I think. And let's pop the stamp down. And ink it up. It's big stamps, so it'll take a little bit of inking. That's where the stamping platform is. So much. It's really worth the money to get one of these because you can just keep going backwards or back onto it if you've missed a bit, which I no doubt will. Little bit here. Let me move. There we go. Let's give it another go over. Trying to make it nice and dark. Keep going. Sorry, the light's a bit weird. The sun doesn't come out all of a sudden. There we go. Let's and let that dry slightly. Tidy this up. We'll wait for the page to dry and then we'll come back and pop the butterfly in. Okay, so everything's dry. I'm going to stick this butterfly on. Hope the camera doesn't fall and hit me on the head. Can't attach it to my table because I have a box behind the desk, which is in the way. Oh. Okay. Nothing left in there. Let's try to do this. This should work. Hopefully. I'm not overly thrilled with the background, but I think I've spent enough time on it. So I've got a grey marker and I'm just going to draw in the antenna because there's no way I was going to be able to cut that out. That's okay. I was thinking that that might be it, but I've just had an idea. Maybe adding a little bit more stamping just to add something to that background. So I'm just going to go and grab a stamp. Okay, so I just grabbed one of my Tim Holtz back candy stamps. I think I'm going to grab a purple to begin with. Up randomly, just a bit of interest, really. Let's try a bit of blue as well, maybe. That's that one. Prize ribbon. That was Dusty Concord. Let's have some of this. Let's just bring it up a little bit of the pink in the pink raspberry. Let's go for the top. Halloween stamp. Yes, this is from a Halloween set. It's mostly my Halloween stamps in this folder, but it's the closest, closest one to hand. And we've got this splattery thing. Do I do it in the grey or do I do it in black? I think grey. Use the hickory smoke, didn't we? Subtle. tone down some of those colours. Okay. Well, I think that's going to be the best I'm going to get on that one. I am going to add a little bit of black, just a little bit. I've got this against Halloween stump, it's the definition of a skeleton. And I'm just going to not ink the whole lot, I'll just do a little bit. Yeah, you can just see that. Which is good. Now, let's add a title and then we're going to end it there, I think. Yes, so embrace your imperfections. What else? Tell your story. What's that? Just need to help it stick a little bit. And have today as a gift. Let's stick it on straight. There we go. I'm just going to add a messy, messy border. I just feel like it needs framing, this one, for some reason. Perhaps because it's quite chaotic. It needs a little structure, maybe. Just what I was feeling, so. There we go. Let's add a date. And it's the 30th of September 22. There we go. I've finished it finally. I can't even remember when I started it, months ago. But there we go. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you again soon. Bye.